Okay, this is intended to be an LTSpice demo. And LTSpice is on the college computers. And it is free software, so you can load it without cost onto a personal. It does require some extra things, and make sure you get it from a reliable source if you choose to put it on your computer at home. For me, I'm going to double click on the icon. I'm running it on Linux, so an emulator's got to open, and then Spice will open beyond that. And there's your blank screen. And this is basically analysis, circuit analysis. Your toolbar up here, everything's grayed out, so you have to do a select new, a new schematic, or file new. So you got to navigate to one of those two places. It's like a lot of Windows programs, there's more than one way to do it. So I now have a new schematic, and we just want to do a very simple circuit. And one of the things that we're going to start with is we want to replace a component, and that's where you have to go to get voltage sources. When you click on component, you get this large list of different components possible. If you go over to voltage, you can select a voltage source, and then you can tailor it to be whatever you want. So I just click on voltage source, select voltage source, and I put it somewhere on my background. Now it is prompting me to put on a second one. So if I have a bigger circuit with more than one voltage source, I can put all my voltage sources in. And if I only have one, as in this case, I can just hit the escape key, and that gets me out of placing a voltage source. Up here across the toolbar, there is a resistor icon directly, so I can click on the resistor. I don't like the fact that it's up and down, so if I want to rotate it, I can control R. Rotate, control R. And if I hit control R again, it'll keep going. So, there we go. And then I can place a resistor in my circuit, and I'm going to place another resistor in my circuit. And then I'm going to escape because I only want two. As with multi-sim, you have to have a ground. The ground component is up there on the toolbar. So if I select that, I can put a ground in my circuit, and I can put as many as I want in my circuit. Now there's a wire icon, so I got to select wire, and then I can connect the dots, if you will, to connect my circuit the way it's laid out. So I'm going to make all my circuit connections. So what I have here is two resistors in series with one common voltage source, and it will keep drawing wires until I hit the escape key. I also want to go in and label my wires. So there is a label, and I'm going to label it 1, and I'm going to make that wire number 1, and escape. Anytime you lose the schematic, you can auto zoom, and there's a shortcut key where zoom to fit means you just hit your space bar, so you can navigate to it and you can do a space bar. To place components and resistors, you can navigate to the edit, and you can find your common components, resistor, capacitor, but you have to go to component to sub-select the voltage. And there's a shortcut key for that, F2. So I've lost it. If I hit my space bar, it comes back, and it's as big as the screen. So I want to do another one, and we'll call that one 2. Click OK. You don't have to label the wires, but you'll see why in a minute. What is happening is the wire connected to my ground is always going to be wire 0 in any simulation program. And then what it will do is it will arbitrarily assign wire numbers based on the schematic, or you can assign them yourself so you know what you've got. Okay, so I made this wire number one, this wire number two. I need to go in and set my voltage values. So I navigated to the voltage, I right mouse clicked, and let's say I'm going to make that 12 volts. And then if I navigate to my R1 so I can edit it, I can put in a resistance value. So I'm going to do a 60 ohms. And I'm going to do 260 ohms is what I'm going to do. Okay. So this is the graphical representation of a circuit. And I want to be able to simulate it and run it and get values. And the nice thing about LTSpice and other simulation programs is it'll give you the values. All you got to do is be able to draw the circuit, make all the proper connections, and then tell it you want to see what the values would be. I have to go to simulate and edit simulation command. Transient is going to be typically used for AC, the AC that we'll do in the AC class. And for DC, it's even simpler. We have a DC operating point. It's a .op. You just select it, click OK, put it on your schematic somewhere. You've got to put it, that .op on there. If you don't have it, it won't simulate because it's looking for that command. It's looking for you to tell it what do you want it to simulate or how do you want it to interpret. So now if I go to run, I get this window that comes up and says, OK, V1 has 12 volts. So the voltage at 1, which I labeled as 1, is 12 volts. The voltage at 2 is 6 volts. And that's all reference to my ground, which is by definition 0 volts. It's telling me that my current through R2, my second resistor, is a tenth of an amp. And my current through R1 is a tenth of an amp. So I've got that window that tells me all that. After I hit the simulation command, if I hover over a wire, what you see is I get like a probe. And if I click on it, real time, it will tell me what the voltage is. And if I click here, it will tell me that I've got 6 volts. And I should be able to click on one side of your resistor as long as I don't go to node 0, which is by default 0. And it will tell me the voltage drop across a component. As long as you're not going to node 0. Because if you know the voltage on one side of it and you go to node 0, then your voltage drop is 6 volts. If you don't light anything on your schematic, there is a scissor icon. And you can cut off the ones you don't want. You could actually cut out components also. And then hit escape when you're done to get you back to a plain cursor. Well, SPICE does this graphically, but the really nice thing about it is you can describe this circuit in terms of a text list. And I'm going to make a change, so it's not the same circuit, but we're going to do this as a text file. So in Windows, you would go to Notepad, Notepad preferable. In Linux, I'm using gedit. And that is my text editor, if you will. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to describe a circuit very similar to this one, but not exactly. So you can see that there will be a difference. So I'm going to name my circuit, which I always will put on my first line. You don't want to start out putting components because that can sometimes confuse these SPICE-based programs. So simple circuit. Now, you want to describe the components. And for your basic components, if I have a voltage source, it's a V. And I can call it what I want to. I can call it V1 like the like my graphical one did. Or I can call it V source. Now, what I need to do is I've established that it's a voltage by V. That tells the program it's a voltage. I've given it a name, which is right there beside it. You don't have to put it in parentheses or anything. And now I've got to tell it where my voltage source is. Well, it's between wire number 1 and wire number 0. So I do a 1 space 0. And that tells me what two wires it's between. And then I can give it my value, 12 volts. I'm going to do the same thing with the resistors. So resistor A is between wires 1 and 2. And it has a value of 60. So let's make it 30. And resistor B is between 2 and 0. And we'll make it 30. Just like in the graphical part, I got to have a simulation, so I'm just going to type dot op, which tells me to tell me the DC values of a circuit. So in most of the DC class, this is the only analysis you'll ever need is the dot op. So now I've got this circuit with the resistors changed to 30 described in a simple text file. And for any circuit that you can, that somebody gives you, you can create a text file. I'm probably going to do text files and then let you draw your own circuits so you see how things go together. This SPICE and circuit net list is what this is called, has been around for about 40 years. People have been describing circuits because they've been letting computers do the circuit analysis. So I've got to save it as something. And then I've got to know where I saved it to. So I'm going to put it on my desktop and I'm going to call it Simple 2. And it is saving it as a text file. So once I get it in a text file and I know where it is, and I know the name of my file, I can close that. And now what I want to do is go into back to LTSpice, do a file, and do an open. Instead of a new schematic, I'm going to do an open. And it's looking in my desktop. Oftentimes you have to navigate to that folder. And it's looking for .asc files. And what we just saved was a .txt file. So if I tell it to look at all files, then I should be able to find Simple 2. There it is. And what you see is it just pulled in the net list that we wrote. And now we can go in and hit the simulate button. Which has a shortcut. And it is Control R, I think. It went by so fast. And this is telling me that my voltage at wire number 1 with respect to wire 0 is 12. My voltage at wire 2 with respect to 0 is 6. And my current through my resistors is 2/10 of an amp. So the IRB is telling me that current through RB, IRA, and V source is actually sourcing 2/10 of an amp. So I'm getting all my analysis. I can't put probes in here, but I can analyze anything I want. So it's a very, very handy tool for doing circuit analysis and very, very handy program. So if I close that, there it is. And that's a good start. That's a simple circuit. Tells you the voltage at each wire, tells you the current through each component. If you know that, you can find out anything you want to know about that circuit. Okay, so if I close my SPICE, let's see, simulate has a shortcut, it's Control R. And if I want to place components, I can't place components because I can't edit, because I'm not in a graphical nature. I am in what we call a net list. So I can go in here and do my net list as a text, And then when I do new, though, it doesn't give me an option for a netlist. So you have to sort of open a netlist or open a text file. It can be a blank text file for that matter. And then you can go in and you can modify it. For instance, if I wanted to make these 15, I can then go in and modify that. That should double my current again. I can control R, simulate it. And you see that my current did in fact double. It went from 2/10 to 4/10. So very powerful tool for circuit analysis. And hopefully this will help you get started. And as you get familiar and you grow in the field, then you'll learn the more advanced functions and all the things it'll do. Very, very powerful stuff. Thank you for watching.